I'm Walter Slezak, and I have a secret.
I've Got a Secret, presented by Winston, America's best-selling, best-tasting filter cigarette. Yes, Winston tastes good, like a cigarette should. Now, Winston Filter Cigarettes bring you America's number one panel show, I've Got a Secret, starring Gary Moore.
Thank you. Bless you. Nice to be with you again. Sorry we missed you last night, but I was watching the elections. I suppose that you were, too. In any event, welcome to another edition of I've Got a Secret. I would like to have you meet our sterling panel, who happily are as follows: Bill Cullen, Jane Meadows, Henry Morgan, Betsy Palmer, and that's about it. Assuming that you are eager to play the game, I will greet our first contestant, please. Will you come in? Please. Panel, I'm not going to ask the lady her name, for if you knew her name, you might possibly know her secret. We will call her Miss X. Miss X, where are you from, as a small clue?
Montana.
From Helena, Montana. Now, Miss X will whisper her secret to me. At the same time, we will share it with our audience at home. To help classify Miss X's secret, it concerns something that happened to her. And Bill, I think we'll start with you tonight, if you don't mind.
All right. Is Miss X not Mrs. X? Is that correct?
Or
is
Miss,
it Miss X? Miss X, the thing that happened to you, Miss X, was it a physical thing?
No.
Could we consider it an honor of some kind?
Yes.
Was something bestowed upon you?
Yes.
Was the thing that was bestowed upon you a title?
No.
Miss X, let's say that there was a title that went with this accomplishment.
You accomplished something then in order to have this thing bestowed upon you, did you, Miss X?
Yes.
And you be...
$20 down, the very bestowal was quite an accomplishment. $20 down, $60 to go, and we go to Jane Meadows.
Miss X, would this title be something other than the first?
Yes.
Would it be something...
Now hold the phone. To be scrupulously honest, there is a title, and then there is also the first.
Oh, yes.
There are two titles involved.
It's like the first Miss something or other?
No.
Miss X, the first.
Miss X the first, yes. Well, now, would we be interested, would it be in the form of arts that you received this honor?
No.
Would it be in the scientific world?
No.
Would it be in education?
No.
Would it be in politics?
Yes.
$40 down and $40 to go, and we go to Henry Morgan, please.
Did it happen yesterday?
No.
Oh, I thought you were a new governor in this statement. Vice Congresswoman of where?
Up in Montana.
Of Montana, really? When did it happen?
I don't know, Henry. Oh. Try it.
Were you the first congresswoman from where?
Montana.
Montana?
Yes.
Thanks, Jane.
That's
not the secret.
No, it happens she was the first congresswoman from Montana, but that isn't...
Well, did you quit? Well, do we want to know when that happened?
I don't know whether it would be helpful to you or not, dependent upon your knowledge of politics. And $60 down and $20 to go. This is so... Well, never mind. Let's go to Betsy Palmer.
Then being a congresswoman, Miss X, isn't what happened to you. That isn't your secret.
Yes. The fact that she was...
Being made a congresswoman was part of the secret that happened to her. You were the first congresswoman that there ever was in the United States.
Oh, you're tough. Panel, this is Miss or Congressman. I'm supposed to say, not Congresswoman. This is Congressman Jeanette Rankin, and she was the first woman ever elected to Congress. She was elected in 1916, which was 4 years before most women in the United States even had the right to vote, simply because the right to vote was bestowed by states, not by the federal government. Now, you were a very active lady before you even went to Congress, were you not?
Yes, I worked for women's suffrage, and we organized the state for women's suffrage, and they sent me to Congress so that I could vote for suffrage in Congress, which I did.
Uh-huh. Now, what was it like to be the first woman to arrive at Congress? Have you any memories of your first day, the first moment that you walked in?
Well, it was very exciting. You see, I had worked in Congress, and I knew Congress, and I thought I'd wait until they were all seated, and then I'd come in quietly. Yes. Instead of that, I waited until they were all seated, and then as I came in, they all rose and greeted me, and it was very interesting.
Isn't that nice? She tried to sneak in, and instead of doing that, she managed to get an ovation for herself. Did you find your fellow congressmen helpful and solicitous?
Oh, they were very kind, and they did everything they could for me, including telling me how to vote.
whether you wanted them to or not. Now, women now have been voting for 40 years. Do you think that this has improved the country necessarily?
Well, I think they've contributed a great deal. They've done as well as the men have, mm-hmm. and they have... more women today want to vote than ever did, and the important thing is for women to want to vote.
Apparently, a great many of them did want to last night. Thank you very much. There are hours that we could talk about here. You have the money that you have won, your carton of Winston's from our client, and thank you very much for being with us, Congressman.